Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Palace Theatre here in the heart of Theatreland. No photos to be taken during the show, unless, of course, a rare species such as an osprey should gain access to the theatre. In which case, it would be a tragic waste of an opportunity to photograph these beautiful birds in flight. But now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your show band for this evening, the Caterers! Tonight, Matthew, I am going to be Morrissey!
A punctured bicycle on a hillside desolate will make you make a man of me, yeah. Hey, it's Johnny Gaw, this charming man. William the Wall, really no pain. Girlfriend in a coma, I know, he's really serious. A panic on the streets of London, a panic on the streets of Birmingham. Hang the DJ, hang the DJ, hang the DJ, everybody. Hang the DJ, hang the DJ, hang the DJ.
Oh, shut up your face. The Caterer is there! Oh, and there they go. Well, of course, I'm not really... Well, he wasn't really Mozza, was it? I'm not really Morrissey. I'm not Mozza. Hey, I'm not Mozza. I was robbed that night. Hey, a pony stroke. Here we are. Look, a pony stroke. A goat stroke. A goat stroke. A bunny stroke. A pony stroke. A goat stroke. A bunny stroke. An elephant. A pat. Now, nice to see you. Oh, yeah, I'm telling you, man, it happened that way, Bacardi Breezer. Well, it's nice to see one or two bald men in the audience. Welcome, sir. The bald man, welcome. Was it the same for you, sir? You just noticed it was taking longer and longer to wash your face. Am I right? Am I right? Back me up on this. Flannels not lasting as long as they should. Am I right? I don't know where the flannels are going. Well, I'm ready to rise again. Well, I found out, I found out this week that my nan has got false teeth. She's got false teeth, so how can I believe a single word that she tells me? Get out of here, you guys slay me. Well, I do think air fresheners must be very confusing for blind people, don't you think? Air fresheners, very confusing for blind people. Pine forest? I thought this was the loo. Now, the 3 bars of soap a week, sir. Am I right? 3 bars of soap. I don't know where the soap's going to. And every now and again, what I like to do, I like to spend about 4 hours just looking from a vehicle registration document. Well, a little bit of fun you can have. A little bit of fun, eh? Even if you haven't got a baby, even if you don't have a baby, when you go out, book a babysitter. You book a babysitter. And even if you haven't got a baby, and on your way out, you say to the babysitter, in about half an hour's time, would you just check on the baby, would you? Even better than that, what you do, you write on one of the doors in the house, a baby's room. You put an empty cot in there. You leave the window open about that much. A little rope ladder. What do you mean the baby's escaped? Oh, give me 50 quid, we'll forget all about it. Now, bowl of oranges. Where's my minicab? Now, Oh, one person clapping by himself, always a bit embarrassing. Particularly after sex, I find. Oh, he's giving flowers out. I wish I sat up the front. Now, Goldfinger. Well, not just jockeys, I think all small people should have to wear a number. Hey? What do you say we run the Grand National till all the horses are dead? Go on, get back round. Hey, get back round, don't come back until you're dead. Don't come back until you're the naughty horses. Oh, hey, the naughty horses. They touch our queen. They touch our queen, the dirty horses. Where do ice cream men get that quantity of stale flakes from, though? Where can you get the stale flakes in that quantity? A taste of honey. Tasting much sweeter than Sealed. Ooh, yum yum sealed.
Ooh, yum yum
sealed. Yum yum sealed.
Ooh, yum yum sealed.
Don't worry, that's right, sir. It's a hand operated torch. Now, the curly whirlies, the holes in the curly whirlies, do they dilute them and turn them into Caramax? Or do they roll them up and pass them off as revels? You, go and find out. Go! Bring back information. Now, I don't know. Back me up on this. I don't know whether you remember when they allowed calculators in the maths exam. No, I can't believe them allowed. Never allowed calculators in the maths exam. What do you mean we've got to show the working out? I asked for the Casio PF100. A lovely calculator, I think you'll agree. It's a lovely one, isn't it? The Casio, a PF100. Unfortunately, my mother, mummy, bought me the Casio PF200, which, as you may know, is an electronic organ. Oh, no, mummy. What did you have to get that one for, mummy? So you can imagine me in the maths exam here. It's the multi-choice, all important. Question one. Question two. But I was clever. I put my hand up. I asked to be excused, went to the lavatory where behind the cistern, previous to the exam, I'd hidden some sheet music. Wasp on a baby's face, sir. What do you do? Wasp on a baby's face. Come on, the clock's ticking. Wasp on a baby's face. The clock's ticking. Wasp on a baby's face. What do you do? Come on. It's an urgent situation. There's a wasp on a baby's face. What do you do? Ah, it stung the baby. It stung the baby. You were too late, weren't you? Come on. Oh, for pity's sake, there's a wasp on a baby. What news of Curly Whirlies? What news of Curly Whirly? Hold it, Curly Whirly. Come on, wasp on a baby's... Slap it! Well, it might make the wasp sting the baby. That's the whole point. Flick it off. You're just digging yourself into a bigger hole. No, you daub your own face with jam and lure it away. What's wrong? You didn't want the jam to drip onto your fancy poncho, is that it? You didn't want the jam to drip onto the fancy bespoke poncho. A little bit selfish, are we? A bit of a bully, are we? The sort of person who might get a younger boy and push him down the wet slide to dry it out for him. Well, a friend of mine, he lives in a castle in Scotland. Rather a nice idea. It was his daughter's second birthday the other day. It's a bit of fun. He put an inflatable council estate in the garden. Rather a nice idea. Now, see, Hitler, he was a bad man. Oh, have I gone too far? He was broadly, just in broad terms, he was a bad man. Winston Churchill, he was a good man, wasn't he? But the odd thing is, if you're in a balloon with Hitler and Churchill and you're losing altitude... The one you throw out is Churchill, because he's the fat one. Go on. Well, give us a hand, Hitler. Come on. See, different games, different rules, isn't it? You see, Mahatma Gandhi loved peace, didn't he? He's a peace-loving man, but if you're looking for a tug-of-war team, Idi Amin, step right up. step right up. Now, that's right, hand-operated torch, you see? Don't be frightened. Pony stroke, a pony stroke, a pony stroke, a goat stroke, a goat stroke, a goat stroke, a bunny stroke, a bunny stroke, a bunny stroke, an elephant pat, an elephant pat, a dog, tickle, tickle. And it's only really when you look at an ant through a magnifying glass on a hot, sunny day, you realise just how often they spontaneously just burst into flame. Here you go. Now, probably the largest shellfish we have in this country must be the donkey. You see them venture up onto the beach at low tide, sometimes wearing a hat, don't they? Occasionally a hat, sometimes a shawl, occasionally a tight-fitting lycra suit. There they are, look. They got four powerful suckers, haven't they? They're hanging on underneath the bottoms of boats, haven't they? And, of course... that's it, yeah, not right. And man, he exploits them, doesn't he? He uses the backs of the donkeys for rides. And I saw a fella, he's got six of them. He's got six donkeys. He's exploiting the backs of the donkeys for rides. And I bought those donkeys and I liberated them back into the ocean, ladies and gentlemen. I took them up onto the pier there and I pushed them off. And they can be stubborn, donkeys are notorious for it. Well, give us a hand, Hitler, come on. Plop, plop, six of them. And I was glad I did because, you know, the next day, those donkeys were washed ashore, dead. But I was happy that before they died, however briefly, they'd gone home. We don't actually know what Jesus looked like, do we, the baby Jesus. As he started off. He started off as the baby Jesus, then he conveniently dropped that bit, didn't he? The baby part. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the artist formerly known as the baby Jesus. We don't actually know what he looked like. There have been various interpretations, mostly bearded. But I imagine that a lot of the time, Jesus just looked surprised. What's going on? Wine? I mean, it was water a minute ago. I didn't know there was a cure for leprosy. Now, okay, wasp on a lady's face. What do you do? Wasp on a lady's face. The clocks. Don't help him. Slap. No, you can't slap it. It might. Come on, wasp on a lady's face. What do you do? It's less urgent, isn't it? Look. Wasp on a lady's face. What do you do? You can't slap it, sir. No, in this situation, all you're obliged to do is to inform the lady of the situation. Now, my nan has got... she's got two left feet, tragically. Yes, thank you for that sympathy. She's got two left feet. Not ideal, but the upside is she's able to steal shoes from outside Dulcis. Now, a left. The odd thing is if she sits cross-legged, she looks perfectly normal. It's an odd one. I mean, she's got two left feet, she's got two right hands. She's got two right hands, but she's left-handed. It's an odd one. She's left-handed. She's got two right hands, so she can hitchhike two places. Oh, yeah, she can get there all right. But she can't get back. Now, but she's clever, my nan. What she does, she is stripped to the waist, and within 10 minutes, there's a squad car to take her home. Now... How old's the Queen Mum now? What, 80? Something like that? About 80? Is she? She must be at least late 70s. The Queen Mum. You think of the number of... You think of the number of foundation stones she's laid in various municipal buildings and hospitals over the years, our Queen Mum. But she'll never take on any heavy structural work. No, she's a typical builder in many ways. She'll turn up on the first day, you never see her again. Remember, of course, about the Queen Mum is that, you know, at the end of the day, she's just a lady, isn't she? She's a lady. Whoa, whoa, she's a lady. Sex bomb, sex bomb. You're the sex bomb. What you gonna do to me? Now, they're very optimistic people, ice cream men, aren't they? Ice cream men. You can tell they're optimistic from the tunes they play in the vans. Ice creams! Ice creams! Mind that child! And it's they're optimistic people, right? So what happens is they get one hot day in April, right? They go out, right? I think all summer's here. They go out, they buy a whole load of flakes. Of course, the weather turns. Those flakes are going to last them all summer. But it's the optimistic sound of the ice cream van that brings the whales in, isn't it? The whales swimming out at sea. Here they are, look. They come in too shallow, don't they? They come in too shallow. They beach themselves in the shallow part.
Chalk eyes. Chalk eyes.
Now, do you want to meet them? Do you want to meet them, the caterers? I know you're all, yes, exciting, isn't it? Do you want to meet them? Here we go then. It's the caterers, ladies and gentlemen. Here they are. Oh, it built. It started small, but it built, Steve. Now, there's Steve, of course. There he is on the on the Yamaha Clavinova PF. It's a joint Christmas and birthday present, Steve. It's a little more than we like to spend on a main gift. And so he skips a birthday, comes around again. It's Christmas now. That's new, isn't it? That's hot. It's the top one. It's a hot plate, isn't it? You've got a Savaloy and you've got a jacket potato on there for later. Now, and this here is Mark. This is Mark. Now, we're teaching Mark how to count, basically. What we're doing, we're using song, which he does understand, to teach him something he doesn't understand, which is count. Shall we show them? Oh, my darling, knock three times. On the ceiling if you want me. Twice on the pipe. If you ain't gonna show. There they are. Oh. Pizza. 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 Well, I don't know. I don't know whether you have these. You've heard of these, have you? Have you seen these before? Have you? You've seen these? The large cardboard mittens. They're they're ideal for the old folk at winter. No, of course it isn't. It's a shredded wheat, isn't it? There he is. There's the shredded wheat. A ripple of excitement passes through the palace theatre. Is he going to hand them out? No, I've got a seat down the front now. There it is, the shredded wheat. Now, you're probably like me. You look at people in hats and you wonder how much milk you could smuggle under the hat. How much milk you could smuggle under the...
Lazarus, what are you doing here? I thought you were dead. What's going on?
tub. Tub.
How much milk you could smuggle under the hat. That's why they give milkmen the flat hats, isn't it? They give them the flat hats so they don't walk off with the merchandise. Right? It makes sense. We all do it. We all walk away with stuff from the office. I might be staying in a hotel locally. I might walk off with perhaps a flannel, a bath towel. Obviously, a Corby trouser press is a quite different proposition. It's a long coat and a skateboard.
Good night.
But that's why we give the policemen the tall helmets, isn't it? We give them the tall helmets. We know they could get a pint of milk under that helmet, but we trust them, don't we? We're testing them. We're testing them. We're saying, look, there's the fridge packed full of milk. There's your tall helmet. Just try it. Go on. Just try it. But the hat I like is the jester's hat, right? Because under the jester's hat, you can get a pint and a half of each of the three different milk species. You get a pint and a half of skimmed. You can get a pint and a half of semi-skimmed. You can get a pint and a half of full fat milk under that hat. You can walk through customs with 4.5 pints of all three of the different milk species, and they've got no way of knowing. They've got absolutely no way of knowing how much milk you've got under that hat. The odd thing is, there's no actual restriction on the amount of milk you're allowed to take through customs. It's a loophole. Yeah, you can walk through customs with 4.5 pints of milk. You can have butter strapped underneath your cagoule. You can have a suitcase with a false bottom packed full of processed cheese, and there's nothing they can do about it. They can't touch you. I'm the milk jester, and I'm back in town. Well, my parents split up, tragically. Yes. Thank you. You like that lining, so do you? It dazzles. It excites. They did. They did split up, tragically. Tragically. My dad became more and more deaf, relied increasingly on lip reading, and my mum, almost as if to spite him, became a Muslim fundamentalist. Your dinner's in the oven! Your dinner's in the oven! Pizza! Pizza! They did split up. Strawberry Mivy. They did split up. My mum got custody of me. My dad got custody of my sister. And she would look at me and think, poor old Harry, he misses a father figure. So she'd nip upstairs. She'd put on a big black curly wig, a big black curly moustache, a football kid. He'd come downstairs and say, come on, so we'll go play football over the park. Come on, go play football. So we'd go play football, and she was pretty good at football. She knew all the moves. Dribble, 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 dribble. Pass. Think of the other fella. Man up. Where were you? On the head. Goal. And it was during one of these particular matches that she was spotted by the then Liverpool team manager, Bill Shankly, who signed her up. She went on to have a very successful career, both nationally and internationally, under the name of Ian Rush. In the meantime, at the other side of town, there's my sister. My father looks at my sister. She misses a mother figure. He'd nip upstairs, a blonde wig, tight-fitting top, heavily pleated skirt, white socks, ice skates. Come on, go play down the ice rink. Go skating down the ice rink. She was pretty good at ice skating, my dad. And it was during one of these particular rink outings that he was spotted by the then Olympic team manager, signed him up. He went on to have a very successful career under the name of Jane Torville. The other side of town, I'm looking at my mum thinking she misses a daughter figure. I nip upstairs, a long ginger wig, a tight-fitting gingham frock, freckles, a white socks, a little pair of red tap shoes, just going to tap dancing lessons. It's during one of these tap dancing lessons, I was spotted by the then producer of Junior Showtime, and I went on to a very successful career under the name of Bonnie Langford. Oh, you've heard of me. In there's my sister on the other side of town, looks at my dad, misses a son figure. She nip upstairs, looks right again, oh, tell me about that, you know, Macaulay Culkin.
Now, what's that lovely Lionel Richie number? Is it one of yours?
You're once, twice,
three times a lady.
Sex bomb, sex bomb, you're the sex bomb. What's your name? What's your name? What's your name? What's your name?
Well, spare a thought for the poor chamois deer, though. Here we are, this poor chamois deer. Here he is gamboling through the forest. The chamois deer with its super-absorbent skin, isn't it? Its super-absorbent skin that we might wipe our heads. Cars, heads, cars, heads, cars, heads, cars. The chamois deer, here he is, gamboling through the forest with his friends. The elk, the Thompson's gazelle. Oh, yeah, I've done the homework. I'm on the internet. Bad boy, dirty boy, in your bed. The chamois deer is gamboling through the forest with his friends, and suddenly it starts raining. It's all right, I'll catch you up, I'll catch you up. I'll catch you up. Now, and you're probably like me, every now and again your mind goes back to a previous lifetime, does it? For me, it's 2 BC when I was an Egyptian slave boy. Ah! Mustafa, Pharaoh is thirsty. Bring more wine. Yes, master. Ah, the picture fades. Now, we've... Stack of four terrapins, sir. Where do you place yourself? Stack of four terrapins. We've all seen them stacking on the box. Where do you place yourself in that stack? No, you've got to be on... It's either on the bottom, there, or look, it's a finger diagram. What's up with you? Second from the top. That tells us a lot about you. Now, with the smaller ones, right? See the little ones, the bite size. Oh, excitement, see? Yeah, you're all thinking, yeah, they're smaller, there's more of them. Maybe he will hand them out. The shreddies, the cruel, orphaned byproduct of the cruel shredded wheat trade. The little tiny orphans, look. There he is. Look. Here he is. Look, I'll demonstrate it now. See, that's the mummy, right? That's the mummy who's been taken away, all right? And here's the... I'm going to have to kill that one as well. I'm going to have to kill the pair of them. Play something suitable. There we are. Tragic. Here they are. Here we are. Here we are. Look, it's number 14.
Wolverhampton Wanderers.
We'll play number 12.
Stockport County.
No, because they're smaller. Now, we've all seen them on the street corners, haven't we? We've all seen them on the street corners. Many of them smoking. Many of them on drugs. They've got no jobs to go to. And once a week, we see them queuing for the state handouts. Or pensions, as they call them. I've actually worked out why old people look the way they do, right? We have to go back to first principles. You take a difference between a raisin and a grape, basically, is... Anyone got that? It's moisture, isn't it? Don't look for hard answers in these, sir. Don't look for something difficult. These are the easy ones. All right, here's one. Here's a hard one for you. Names of celebrities whose surnames suggest they should be good at DIY. Come on, Barry. All right, is it Barry? Celebrities whose surnames suggest they should be good at DIY. MC Hammer, we've got up the back there. You see, he's... The streets ahead. Okay, the difference between a grape and a raisin is... Stop thinking. I know you're thinking of them. Stop thinking about them now. I don't want any more now.
Don't want any more.
The difference between a grape and a... The difference between a grape and a raisin is moisture, right? If you open a packet of biscuits, right, within a couple of days, if you leave them open, those biscuits have gone soft. Why? Because they draw in moisture. If you get an elderly lady, you open a handbag, what do you find? Biscuits. I rest my case. Now, poor old Nan, she died tragically. Yes. Yes, thank you. It's building, isn't it? It's building that, the sympathy sound. It's been a terrible week in many ways for me. This is the culmination of a terrible week. The only silver lining is that I had a rice pudding for lunch, and rather nice. And you know how the pot, the skin gets sort of baked on to the outside of the pot there. Before I came out tonight, I put it into soak. So forgive me if I appear smug. Oh yes. When I get home, one quick wipe. That's all it'll take. What's that number the going on song that you wrote? I am 16. What have we started here?
Going on 17.
Trained in Tai Chi to back you into a parking space. You'll be there all day. Well, give us a hand, Hitler. Now, my nan, she died tragically. Basically, she died of a hoarse voice. Well, to be specific, she drowned, in fact. Help! She was depressed. She'd just come out of the bingo. She'd had a successful line, but was unable to claim the prize. House. But she worked the funeral out to the last detail, ladies and gentlemen. She wanted that beautiful gospel number at the funeral.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
When Jesus washed.
When Jesus washed.
All the sins away.
There was a clerical error at the crematorium. And instead, as the coffin disappeared through the curtains for the last time, what we actually heard was...
Tuesday.
Happy day.
Thursday.
Happy day.
Saturday.
Happy day.
Saturday.
What a day.
Rocking all week with you.
Today's your
eyes. Happy days are yours and mine.
Happy day to you.
You see, they put the war memorials up, didn't they? They put the war memorials up so we remember the war dead. Isn't that right, Barry? We come out of Timmy Mallett. You could have had Timmy Mallett's one.
you might have been thinking about.
You come out of the house, right, you see the war memorial, you think, oh, war dead. And of course, this is in the days before post-it notes. Now, vegetarians, they tend to be the same people who go on about the environment, aren't they, in my experience, the vegetarians. Now, maybe there'd be a bit more environment about if they wasn't eating all the plants. You can marry your auntie, can't you? There's not a problem with that. There's no law against it, is there? You can marry your auntie. Hmm? A strange woman who kisses you every time you see her. She's trying to tell you something, isn't she? Read the signs.
Auntie!
She's perfect, isn't she? She's the perfect woman. She looks a bit like your mum. And she's younger and not married to your dad. Hmm? Have you thought of one, then? Have you thought of one? Jimmy Nail, I'll accept. Very good. Very well done to you. Yeah. You'll notice that that gets a round of applause, fellas. Apparently. That. Yes, jolly good. Anyone else got any? Oh, we're all off now, aren't we? Oh, yes. Oh, we've all thought of one in the intervening 10 minutes. Harry Carpenter. We'll accept, yes. It's a good one. Hmm? Jackademus and Pliers is a clever one. Jackademus and Pliers. Yes, I haven't thought of that one. It's a night. I can't believe how busy we are on the phones tonight. Hello? Oh, hello, Chris. Yeah, put him on. Yeah. Hello, Bob. Yes. Yeah. 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 I think it's D, Wisconsin. Good luck. Now, when I was younger, we used to say quite a lot, hey, it's the Fonz. But 9 times out of 10, it wasn't the Fonz. So that would be followed by, hey, it's the Fonz. Oh, no, it's not the Fonz. And most of us grew out of it. One lad, he would go on and on about it. Hey, it's the Fonz, time after time. But one night, moving on up. We're about our business there, like that, and he goes, hey, it's the Fonz. Well, we didn't even bother looking up from our work. We didn't even bother looking up.
Yeah, I know. Hey, it's the Fonz.
Yeah, yeah, all right, yeah, we pull the other one. We didn't even look up from our work. And he goes, hey, no, look, it is the Fonz. Yeah, 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 we believe you. Look, please, look, it is the Fonz. Yeah, yeah, we believe you. Pull the other one. We've been out too many times, mate. And you know, that night, the Fonz killed and ate 14 of our best sheep. The story there of the boy who cried Fonz. Now, and now, ladies and gentlemen, the previous Secretary of State for Northern Ireland's husband are telling her that their grass needs cutting. Mow my lawn. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the First Minister of the Northern Ireland Assembly's wife are telling him that their cow needs a haircut. Thank you. David Trimble. Thank you. And now, a prominent member of Sinn Féin's wife inquiring about her drink. Martin McGuinness. This is the part of the show that I like to call the Good Friday Agreement fun spot. Laughter in a crisis, and to round it up, the Prime Minister of Southern Ireland's wife interrupting him at a party. Thank you. Bertie, Now, some of you may have noticed this item. This is a, that's right, it's a gymnastics mat. Hmm? Oh, yeah, it's a... It's a gymnastics mat. I do apologise. I can't find my vehicle registration document anywhere. It's a gymnastics mat, and coming up, we've got the history of popular music gymnastics display, which, in my view, is the high point. Yes, What I do is I distill all the different forms of music over the 20th century into six basic gymnastics moves. It's just something to look forward to. Now, presumably, if you're training to be a bullfighter, you don't start straight in on bulls, do you? No. Presumably, first day, a bullfighter, you have to wrestle a chicken to the floor. It's on my back! It's on my back! The chicken's on my back! I call the teacher! I call the teacher! Day two. Presumably, you can just walk up to a sheep and punch him in the face. Hey! Well, my own marriage is broken up as well. Basil Brush. There's another one you could have had. My own marriage broke up. I say marriage. We never actually got the paper through from the Philippines in the end, but... So a friend of mine, Andy, Dave, you're probably like me, you say Andy and you mean to say Dave. He arranged for a blind date. He said, I know a rich widow. He said, you can go out and have a lovely drink with this rich widow. So we went out with the rich widow. We had a lovely evening. She invited me back to her place. We get in there, and she says, I'm just going to go and slip into something more comfortable. Off she goes. While she's away, I look up. I notice there are all these balloons full of blood hanging from the ceiling. I thought, that's odd. And while she's gone... I noticed this, and then she comes back, and she's completely naked, except for one of those musical socks like you get at Christmas. Yeah? You know the musical socks like you get at Christmas? I'll just turn it off, save the battery. She's got a broom handle with a nail sticking out in one hand. She bends over, she activates the sock. She bursts one of the balloons. She hands me the broom handle and says, go on, your turn. Well, I made my excuses and left. But you know, the next day I phoned that friend of mine. I phoned him. I said, Andy, Dave. I said, that rich widow. He said, widow? No. Weirdo. Good night, Jeff. Good night, Jeff. Oh, here we go. 76 trombones hit the big parade.
John and Jen Cornette's on the line. Thump, right? It's a proper joke. I've only got one. 99 thump. What goes? Anyone? No, an ice cream man being mugged. No. We...
Get out of here. You can't slay me.
And Macaulay Culkin. Hello, everyone. Wait a minute. What am I doing here? I was crucified 3 days ago. Have you thought of one? Do you think of one, Barry? Oh, Bonnie Tyler, yes. Very good. Yes. Nice one. Nice one. Around. You get around for that one. Anyone else? Anthea Turner. Anthea Turner, no, it's a specialist job. you need specialist machinery. I cannot allow it. Peter O'Toole we've had down the front. Very good,
Nigel
yes.
Planer.
Nigel Planer's a nice one. Yeah, fun, isn't it? But is it entertainment? you don't really need me here for that, do you? Now, there's never been Roger Black and Desmond Decker. That's my favourite. Individually, no. But together as a team, yes. You never see any Dutch... There's never been, like, a really well-known Dutch detective, has there? There's never been, like, a really... well-known Dutch detective, is there? If you think of it, there's a very good reason for that. If you think about it, it's very difficult to creep up on someone wearing wooden shoes.
No, go away. Oh, go away.
Now, oh, Mustafa, how did you gain access to Pharaoh's bedchamber? The picture fades. I'll be honest with you, I'm a bit upset this week because my bum bag burst. I can't find my vehicle registration document. Wait a minute, what did I tie that knot in there for? Oh yeah, war dead. Now, you're probably like me, divide people into two broad groups according to their personality traits. Do you? The cats and the snakes. Back me up on this. You do. You divide people into two broad groups, the cats and the snakes according to their personality traits. Am I right?
Back me up on this.
If you like, madam, I can allocate you which broad group you fall into. You up for that? The cat or the snake? The snake. You up for that? Okay. If you'd like to tell me a bit about yourself, I can allocate you which group you fall into. What's your name? For starters, Sam, short for Samantha, short for. Okay, and you have you've been allocated a surname, have you? Okay, what was the surname allocation? Eve, Samantha, Eves, of course. Okay, all the time I'm thinking cat or snake. Which is she, cat or snake? Okay, Samantha, Eves, what do you do for a living? Are you in employment currently? Housewife and mother, of course, very important job, of course, the housewife, isn't it? It's a lot of that, isn't it? And neighbours. Oh, of course not. No, it's more to it than that. And you get the long holidays. No, I do apologise. Here's a washer, dryer, and home and away. No, of course not. Now, the... I do apologise. All the time, I'm thinking cat or snake. Which is she? Okay, do you have a favourite colour, Samantha? Eves? If you had to choose your favourite colour. Blue? Okay, cat or snake? Samantha Eves, she's a housewife. Favourite colour, blue. If you had to choose, which would you rather sleep in? A big wicker basket with a lid or in front of a nice hot fire?
Now, you... You know when you get your... You get the photos back. You get your photos back. You think, what did I take that one for? You think, what did I take that one for? What did I take... Then you remember, you're a crime scene photographer for the...
What did I take that one for?
Have we got any crime scene photographers in at all? Any crime scene photographers? No? Okay. Anyone in who marks out the deceased body at the scene of the murder? Anyone? There's normally a couple, presumably. If you're one of those people, you're driving to the murder scene like that, unconsciously you're thinking, oh, I hope they've died on lino. I think it's something smooth like lino. Because the tape goes down nice and easily, comes up nice and easily at the end. You can reuse it and cut down your overheads. And you get there, and what is it? Carpet tiles. Oh, God. This grit all sticking to the underside of the tape. The carpet tiles are coming up as you're pulling the tape up. Why did you have to die on such a gritty surface? Well, I guess we should wrap things up while we're ahead, fellas.
But, Harry, what about Stufer?
Stufer, I haven't seen him all day.
Oh, Lordy, your trouble's so hard. Oh, Lordy, your trouble's so hard.
I'll see if I can see him.
Nobody know my trouble but God. Don't nobody know my trouble but God. Oh, Lordy, your trouble's so hard. Oh, Lordy, your trouble's so hard. Don't nobody know my trouble but God. Don't nobody know my trouble but God.
It's Stuber, ladies and gentlemen, here it is.
Honey gonna come back sometime. Honey gonna come back sometime. Honey gonna come back sometime. Never
sometime. All right, Stuber, that's enough. That's enough. Oh.
Oh, Mr. Harry, I do like Moby.
Well, how you, for those of you up the back, if you can't see Stuber awfully well, this is what they're seeing. That's what we're seeing down the front. How you doing, Stuber?
Boy, oh, not so happy, Mr. Harry.
Why is that?
Well, I found out why I am the colour that I am.
Oh, why is that? Your mother? With a smurf?
Tell me, Sam, do you like food out of a tin that stinks? Or you like to dislocate your jaw and swallow small mammals whole?
Okay, now,
Larry Sanders.
Yes, you could have had Larry Sanders as a nice one.
Steps.
Steps is a good one. Okay, now, so we've come up with an invention, Stuber and I. That's it, Stuber, you help. There we are. What? We've come up with an invention. You know when you've got a nice piece of fish? Oh, a nice piece of fish, and you can get the vinegar on top of the fish, can't you? That's. But it tends to skate over the surface.
It tends to skate over the surface.
It tends to skate over the surface like...
Like,
What would be a good analogy for that, Stuber?
It skates over the surface like water off a bundle of greaseproof paper.
Yes, that would be a good one. Yeah, a good analogy. You got a better one? So what it is, it's the vinegar duck. I don't know if you can pass that round. Look, what it is, it's a conventional vinegar dispenser with an attenuated... Nozzle. Pass around, madam. Yeah, that's it. Pass that round. Yes, if we all spend that long looking at it, you know, we're not all going to get a decent... you know, just use your loaf for pieces sake, sweetheart. Now, okay, I'm looking for backers. I'm a bit anxious doing that because the last time I came up with an invention, I passed it around like that and I never got the bit of paper back. Yeah. 3 years later, Microsoft Word for Windows.
That was one of your, right?
Yeah, it was one of mine, Stufa. While that is busy circulating, it's absolutely fascinating, isn't it? What I thought we'd do is open the floor for any questions for Stufa.
Yeah, any questions for Stufa.
And an informal question and answer session, if you will, of my tiny blue friend. Anyone got any questions? How old are you? It's a good question for Stufa from the third row back there. Okay, well, I'll put it to him. Tell me, Stufa. How old are you?
Well, I have many ages and many lives.
Yeah, he's a Buddhist. That's basically Buddhism, isn't it? Something to do with lives, anyway.
I can remember any time of any age. I can remember some detail of it.
If you perhaps would like to follow that question up by naming a date, he can give you, see if he can remember. July the 7th. '72. 1972, okay.
Overcast.
Very overcast. It was very overcast that day. That's what sticks in his mind. Any other questions for Buddha? Stufa, sorry. One more question. Have you got a girlfriend from up the back there? Well, I'll put that to him. Have you got a girlfriend, Stufa?
Oh, yeah. I got a girlfriend.
Oh, you asked her out, did you?
Oh, yeah. Shake it up, Stufa. Shake it up.
Did she decline?
No.
Didn't she mind?
I don't think so.
Was it for real?
Damn sure.
What was the deal?
A pretty girl at 24.
So was she keen?
She couldn't wait.
A cinnamon queen.
Let me update.
What did she say?
She said she loved to rendezvous. She asked me what we were gonna do. She stopped with a bottle of Moët for two.
Monday, took her for a drink on Tuesday.
We were making love on Wednesday. On Thursday, Friday, Saturday, chilled on Sunday.
Met the girl on Monday.
Took her for a drink on Tuesday. We were making love on Wednesday. Grazie, bon selector. Sorted, respect you.
Stupid there, ladies and gentlemen, that's all I do. With him. Good night. Better wind up now, fellas, isn't we? You think? What we're going to do, we're going to leave you with some pretty thoughts. So many of our young comedians will send you away with an ugly thought, a profanity even. We're going to send you away with some pretty thoughts. Thank you. Butterfly in blue jeans, hamster in a chiffon top, puppy in a poncho, fluffy duckling with a bomb, butterfly in blue jeans. These are the things of our dreams.
Of our dreams, of our dreams.
These are the things of our dreams.